Justice Leonel.
You are aware of Republic Act 6768, is it not? That is the law with respect to balikbayans.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, and that is the law under which your client, according to you,
yes,
entered Honor. The Philippines, and that meant that it was visa-free.
Yes, Your Honor.
Also, in the correctly written case of Caballero versus Comelec, which was unanimous, didn't the court say that the reacquisition of Filipino citizenship does not per se include the start of residency?
Yes, Your Honor.
Therefore, starting a divorce between citizenship and residency. Is that not correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Yes. Now, let me just get my bearings a little bit here for the next 30 minutes before I go into the technical questions later on, maybe next week. What did your client, Senator Grace Poe, when she was a child, a baby, do to cause the parents to leave her? What did she do to cause the parents to actually leave her?
She does not know, Your Honor, and we do not know.
You mean she did not do anything?
As a foundling,
because she was
born.
A baby, right?
Yes.
She was a newborn baby.
Yes.
And she did not have any moral volition at that point, correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
And it was completely the agency and the moral decision of the parents to actually leave her behind. Is that not correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Is that right?
It's not right as
it's
a matter
wrong,
of moral,
right?
Yes.
Yes, and if we are to define what justice means giving everyone their due. And it can also be the opposite. Whoever does something wrong should be the one to carry the burden of the harm that happens even from society. Is that not correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
You believe our laws are just, correct? Can be just.
Yes, generally they are just.
And we are here not as legalists. We are here as justices, correct?
Correct, Your
the
Honor.
The root word is not legal, but it is just. Meaning to say we do justice in accordance with law, but if we can interpret law so that it does justice, then so be it. Is that not correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
Yes, so we are not completely only legalists, correct? She grew up. Grace Poe grew up. She was lucky. She was found by Edgardo...
Militar.
Militar. He couldn't handle her, so he turned her over to Eduardo Militar.
Emiliano Militar.
Emiliano Militar. And then she was lucky. She was handed over to Susan Roses and Fernando Poe Jr. Is that not correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Okay. Did she have a completely charmed life? Or do you think that when she was growing up, she had also difficulties?
She
those kinds of difficulties where we need our parents.
She would have difficulties.
For example, also. There are rumors that she is actually the child of X and Y. I will not mention because I do not want to hurt her further. Correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
I grew up without a father. It was difficult, but I knew who my father was. But yet it was difficult. But I think those people who do not know who their fathers are, but grew up only with their mother, also have a difficult time. But I think those that do not have a mother and a father and stay with their adoptive parents also have a very difficult time, correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
At the end of the day, should this court ask her to look for those parents that actually left her because she had it lucky? She is now one of the candidates to become president of this republic. Do you think that's a fair result?
That's not fair.
Yes. Fair, not fair. Of course, it's clear to us what should happen in terms of justness. But the question is, can our laws actually contain that kind of a result? Is it clear enough to say that the Constitution of the Republic looks this way on foundlings, that there can never be any foundling found in the Philippines, in a rural area in the Philippines, that can ever become president? Is that correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
Okay, now, how many foundlings are there in the Republic?
Based on records mentioned by Senator Aquino himself, around 4,000, but this is not accurate because
this is the registered number of foundlings, correct?
Not accurate, Your Honor.
Yes. So a foundling, when found by poor people, They spend enough money in order to find the statistics office to register themselves, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So this is an accurate figure because all foundlings actually register even if they are found by other poorer families. Is that not correct?
That's correct. And some
of course
of them...
not, because it is a fact that if you were dirt poor and you found somebody and you wanted to carry on your moral obligation like the Good Samaritan to help this guy or to help this this girl, then you would use your money to buy food rather than to register. Is that not correct?
That's correct, Your
It's
Honor.
A possibility with respect to our foundlings, correct?
That's correct,
And
Your
do
Honor.
You believe that there are only 4,000 foundlings in the Philippines?
No, because most births might have been registered as simulated births.
But your guess is as good as mine, and the fact is that we do not actually know, and that we know the difficulty that they're going through. As she was going through, she had to find her parents during the most difficult times of her life. Is that not correct?
That's correct, Your
And
Honor.
This is one of her most difficult times. Is that not correct?
I would think so, Your
that
Honor.
That she has to lay bare her entire life. Well, she's running for president, that is true, but she is out there, or people are out there for her, asking who the parents are, and have the parents actually come forward?
Not
yet.
Not
so
yet,
these
Your
parents
Honor.
Who left her, through their own volition, through no fault of hers, have not yet come out. And what are we requiring of her to prove her parentage?
To prove the citizenship
yes,
of
DNA
her parents.
DNA testing, correct?
Yes.
And for any other ordinary Filipino, what suffices for us?
Birth certificate.
A birth certificate. Are you sure your father is your father?
No, Your Honor, because I know who prepared the birth certificate. Probably an attendant at the birth. Or hospital administrator.
I pity and you, you'll have to go home to your father, or your father might tell you. But that's true. In essence, somebody prepares that birth certificate. Are there other ways to prove your parentage other than the birth certificate?
Well, apart from the DNA affidavits of persons on family pedigree, which are really in the nature of circumstantial or hearsay evidence.
Okay. Essence, therefore, this question is, how far do we go for foundlings in the Philippines in terms of the evidence, and who carries the burden of proof? Would you agree with me?
I would agree, Your Honor.
Yes. Now, this is also not only about a foundling, but this is like any other case of those 10.8 million Filipinos that go abroad.
Yes, yes, Your
Honor. And 4 million of them actually stay abroad, take up their own citizenship there, but there is a program to bring them back, and this is called the Balikbayan case, correct? So this is not about a simple foreigner wanting to become a president of the Republic. Is that not correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
This is about a Balikbayan, a Filipino, perhaps, who grew here in the Philippines, who wants to come back to actually serve. Is that not correct?
That's correct.
It's like the case of Makiling, correct?
Yes, Balikbayan also.
Yeah, this is Mayor Arnaldo in the town of Kauswagan. Is that not correct? Which in that case, the Supreme Court impliedly said that that person who reacquired Filipino citizenship can run for mayor. Is that not correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Do you know the requirement for being a mayor? Does one have to be a natural born citizen?
I believe just citizenship.
Yes.
Not natural born.
Okay, so this is about foundling, presumptions of burdens of proof, sufficiency of the evidence, procedure to establish that, and about foreigners who are Balikbayans. Is
correct.
That not correct? Well, to be clear, we are going to be voters. Is that not correct?
That's correct.
We are going to cast our ballot, correct?
Correct.
And it will be one among 50 plus million of those that will cast their ballot. Is that not correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
And you think it's legitimate for us as electors, as people who will vote during the election, to consider whether Senator Poe is affluent or not, to consider whether she went to Boston, to consider that his son is in Beacon School, to consider that she once gave up Filipino citizenship, when we select who our president will be. Is that correct?
No, the people should focus only on her eligibility.
No, us as electorates.
Yes.
I mean, I will vote. I have a precinct in Quezon City. Is it legitimate for me as a voter to consider that? As a voter?
Yes.
Not as a justice? Yeah. Is it legitimate for me as a justice to consider that?
Justice would consider legal questions, purpose of the law, equity. I think, yes, just like the electorate itself.
When I decide this case, should I consider who I am going to vote for during the election?
No, Your Honor.
No. I will decide this on the basis of what is legal and hopefully what the outcome is, that it is just, not who I want to be president. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. Because I just wanted that out there, because people seem to be in various media outlets trying to predict how we will vote simply because they identify us as close to this and close to that particular candidate. By the way, how did this information come out in the public? Was it true that it came out because of an announcement made by the Secretary General of UNA?
Yes, in June 2015.
And this started the snowball of,
yes,
questions relating to the qualifications of your client. Is that,
yes,
not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
By the way, is there any political party or candidate for president that has intervened in this case?
Are the private
respondents here representing any political party? Because the truth to say, I know them to be very eminent individuals. I know them from different parts of my lifetime. Senator Tatad, Star Lamparo was my student. Senator Tatad was my boss at some point. Dr. Contreras was my colleague in terms of ecology. And Dean Amado Valdez is a person that I highly respect in terms of the academy and many other things. But I also respect, of course, you know that I know you, I know your partners, etc. So I know for a fact that they are not running for office. So there is no political party that intervened in this case. Is this not correct?
I cannot say that, Your Honor.
Well, in actual fact,
I do not know of any alliances which they may have. So
okay.
I cannot.
In other words, can we assume that the other candidates for presidential election do not really care about this case? They would want to win an election fair and square. Is that not true?
I cannot say that also, Your Honor.
That also might be a speculation,
yes,
correct? Okay. Now, because we are also citizens, and because it is possible that our vote may find its way into the way that we decide, whether we like it or not, because we are human beings. Therefore, the Constitution has a check. Correct?
Yes.
This court usually defers to a political organ if it is clear in the Constitution that that political organ is made to decide first. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
By the way, who ratifies the Constitution?
The people.
The people.
Yes.
When we ask that the people ratify the Constitution, do we assume that they can read the Constitution?
Yes, and we also assume they take into account the...
When they can read the Constitution, do we assume that they have their interpretation of that Constitution?
We assume also that they take into account interpretations of the framers.
Yes. Well, I do not know with respect to the framers, but I am asking about the people, because as far as the people are concerned, they are confronted with text. But the point there is that when we ask the Constitution to be approved, we trust the people enough to be able to approve the fundamental law or not. Is that,
yes,
not correct?
Your Honor.
Yes. Suffrage is an aspect of sovereignty. At the same time, it is a personal right. Is that,
yes,
not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Suffrage is one of the direct exercises, perhaps the only direct exercise, where people actually select their agents in terms of the government. Correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Yes. And therefore, should you say that this court should evolve a doctrine that in terms of this, that we should first allow the people to decide and then we become the final arbiter should there be a contest?
Yes, especially since all that the respondents have achieved is to cast doubt. So let the people be the judge.
Is that not contemplated in the Constitution today?
Yes, Your Honor, the electoral process itself is the occasion for the people to decide.
Okay. I have 15 minutes, so I'll just go to some of the preliminary questions. What is our existing Constitution?
1987 Constitution.
Not the 1935 Constitution? Because a while ago you were discussing the intent of two people in the Constitutional Convention discussing the 1935 Constitution. So for one moment there, I was thinking, are we using the 1935 Constitution?
Well, we're using the 1935 Constitution, but what I meant to say is that principles on nationality have been carried over in substance or generally to the current Constitution.
Yeah, but it's still the 1987 Constitution that we are interpreting, correct? And as far as we are concerned, constitutions apply to different historical periods. Justices are not amateur historians only, that what we do is try to find out what happened in the past and apply it today. Justices, I think, of the Supreme Court, in my view, are people who read the text of the Constitution and only its text in order to find out the meaning within the four corners of that document and apply it to a situation which may not have been contemplated at that point. Is that not correct?
I agree, Your Honor.
Was there any discussion on foundlings in the 1972 or 71 Constitutional Convention?
I'm not aware, Your Honor.
Was there a discussion on foundlings in the 1987 Constitution?
Unfortunately, I'm not
aware. Was there ever a time in our history that a foundling actually ran for president?
I'm sorry, I cannot answer that also,
Your Honor. There ever a time? None. Was there ever a time that there was a vice president that ran as a foundling? A foundling that ran as vice president, I'm sorry. None, right?
Yes.
This is the first time that this court is going to lay down doctrine with respect to foundlings. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. Don't you think it's the better part of prudence that we follow what the Constitution said, that the Supreme Court has jurisdiction over electoral contests to determine the returns, the qualifications of candidates. And in Texon, Supreme Court's contests mean, and contests means after election. Is that
yes,
not correct?
Honor.
Of course, we have the provision in the Omnibus Election Code, which actually says that we have 64 jurisdiction, Rule 64 jurisdiction, over actions of the COMELEC. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. But on that, all that we can do is to check whether there was capriciousness, whimsicality, arbitrariness with the COMELEC being tasked to do exclusively to determine whether there was false material misrepresentation. Is that
yes.
not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, okay. Can I show you Article 7, Section 4, and I will end with this because I will consume my 30 minutes. Article 7, Section 4. The design of the Constitution was that the President and the Vice President be elected by direct vote. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. I go to the fourth paragraph. There is participation by Congress to canvass. Is that not correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. That is the fourth paragraph of that section. It is Congress that canvasses, not the COMELEC. And finally, the sixth paragraph, the Supreme Court comes in after all of that, shall be the sole judge of all contests relating to the election. Is that not correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
I'll show you Article 9C, Section 2, the powers of the COMELEC, on the other hand. So, Section 2, Paragraph 1. Enforce and administer all laws, regulations relative to the conduct. A lot has been said about number 1. Is that not correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Now, look at number 2. The adjudicatory jurisdiction of the COMELEC only refers to what kind of officials, please?
Local officials.
Regional, provincial, and city officials, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, the power to adjudicate on qualifications per se has not been granted to COMELEC. Their sole power is to enforce and administer all laws. And to administer all laws, don't you think that preliminarily, determining whether or not a person is natural born or whether domicile, a legal concept, has been established, is within their jurisdiction?
Only preliminarily, but the main issue
or is their jurisdiction only with respect to facts which they allege, which the candidates allege, that can lead to the inference of all of this. And their jurisdiction is whether or not those facts are false.
Yes, Your Honor.
For example, how old is the candidate? She is, I'm not sure. Okay? For example, how did she establish her residence? From her point of view, she will lay down the facts, correct? But the interpretation is a matter of opinion, correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
It's a matter of law. To do so would be to adjudicate. Is that not correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
I will stop here because I did agree to only 30 minutes, but I reserve my other questions, Chief, for the other minute.
This has been quite a long afternoon, but a very productive one, and we thank everyone for participating. But upon the earlier advice I had given, we will be resuming our session at 2 o'clock next Tuesday, exactly the same venue, with Justice Leonen resuming his interpellation. Session is hereby adjourned. All right.
Thank you. Thank you, Your Honors.
Please remain standing while the Chief Justice and the Associate Justices leave the session.